carrying out the continuity test, we're going to have to measure it in the SI units of ohms. In order to use this tester, we're going to only use the red and green input points for our leads and not the blue. We'll only be using that during our live testing process. Our continuity test is done dead. Leads are in. I'm going to set it onto ohms because we're measuring resistance. And we're going to be using our link. Because we're using a link, this link could be broken, and we must confirm that it is also continuous. By linking it across the ends of my probes, I should see that we get an achievable reading. The MFTs automatically start the ohm reading, so you don't have to press any test buttons, and we've got 0.01 of an ohm for the resistance of the link itself. It's not broken. If it was broken, if I take it off, the reading would be huge. So we've proved the link is continuous. First test. Okay, happy with that. Because the leads themselves are made of resistive material, we're also going to need to prove that they are in circuit and of zero value. By linking them together and holding tight, I've got flashing zero. On this instrument, flashing zero isn't zero. I need zero on its own. In order to null the leads, I press the test button. I now have a reading, which again is not zero. To press it once more, I've now got zero itself. Is zero flashing? No, it isn't. That means we're ready to start this test.